courage.
I don't do my work thinking in terms of what effect it might have on politics in the future. I do my work as well as I can do it.
Vision.
And you've got the kind of advertising that seems to equate success with smoking. I think it's a very dangerous and a very insidious thing.
Leadership.
I tell you now, I care.
These qualities made Leroy Collins one of the most revered and successful of Florida's governors.
He used his position as governor to transform the state. He didn't do little things. I'm sure he was pretty good at that too, but he did big things. And so I've always admired him.
History of Florida could have really been a lot different had he never got elected governor.
When I first ran for the legislature, I was determined to do something about public education in Florida.
Elected to the State House in 1934, Collins served 8 years before his election to the State Senate. The future governor resigned to serve in the United States Navy during World War II. Elected to the Senate again in 1946, he served there until he won a special election to fill the term of deceased Governor Dan McCarty.
Florida, as you know, is approaching the climax of a turbulent political drama.
This 1954 election was the first in Florida to feature televised gubernatorial debates.
I just wanted to ask the acting governor something about this. Now, here's a copy of tomorrow morning's Herald. And it's an official advertisement by acting Governor Johns. And he says, proof that truth is mightier than the syrupy mouthings. Governor Johns' direct talk to the people of Dade wins wide support. Now, this is in the morning's paper, not this morning.
I am Leroy Collins.
From the moment he was elected, Governor Collins had ambitious plans.
We must not hesitate. So much to be done. So little time.
I had a very ambitious program as governor. Oh, I must have had 15 different aspects of state government that I was anxious to change.
Collins took office at a critical point in the history of the nation, the American South, and the state of Florida. The U.S. Supreme Court's landmark Brown versus the Board of Education decision desegregating public schools had occurred a year earlier. Tempers were boiling. Governor Collins took to the airwaves to calm the fears of anxious citizens.
Friends, we've got mobs beginning to form now.
And to issue a courageous call for moderation.
We've got this mob shouting here. We've got this mob shouting there. But where are the people in the middle? Why aren't they talking? Why aren't they working? They must start working.
In 1957, Governor Collins opposed a legislative resolution that sought to block racial integration. Although he was powerless to prevent passage of the so-called interposition resolution, he made this memorable statement in his own hand on the resolution. I decry it as an evil thing, whipped up by the demagogues and carried on the hot and erratic winds of passion, prejudice, and hysteria. If history judges me right this day, wrote Collins, I want it known that I did my best to avert this blot. If I am judged wrong, then here in my own handwriting and over my signature is the proof of guilt to support my conviction. From the beginning of his campaign for governor, Collins was a role model and mentor to governors who would follow and who all call him the greatest governor Florida ever had.
He is a symbol of the kind of leadership that Florida needs.
He was a guy that had all the attributes that you would like a governor to have. First of all, total integrity, you know, and undaunted, unlimited courage.
Governor Collins' accomplishments are many. He was a big thinker, developing programs that have endured to this day. Governor Collins was instrumental in establishing what is today the Great 28, Florida's state college and community college system.
It took a visionary leader to do that, and a state that had a legislature that wasn't necessarily the most progressive in the world or future oriented followed suit.
As a senator, Collins championed the protection and maintenance of Florida's state parks and monuments. The 1949 State Parks Act, a result of the Collins Bill, remains virtually intact today as the basis for Florida's nationally renowned park system. Collins also provided the momentum for the plan that levels school funding between rich and poor counties, guaranteeing equal education opportunities for the children of the wealthy and the workers alike.
We had some good schools and some horrible schools, but there was no uniform level of achievement that the state demanded and was willing to pay for.
Collins was also instrumental in the creation of Florida's public television system.
I wanted us always to be alert to opportunities because there were so many changes that were developing.
It was Leroy Collins who fought to create fairly drawn political districts that guaranteed equal representation.
We have a horrible situation in Florida, worst in the United States. We had 17% of the population of Florida electing over a majority of the legislative representation in Florida. And that was just unbelievably wrong.
Collins was never able to convince lawmakers to deal with the issue directly.
In time, the courts are going to step in.
Chief Justice, may it please the court.
His efforts, however, paved the way for the landmark U.S. Supreme Court decision Baker versus Carr that allowed the federal government to intervene and require fair districts in each state.
Governor Collins, 51 years old, graduated.
On the national stage, his efforts were not unnoticed.
He was the first Florida governor to be elected for two consecutive terms and the first in his state's history to win a first primary victory when he received more votes than his five opponents combined.
Collins was recruited to run for vice president, but chose not to.
It didn't make really good political sense.
But he did chair the 1960 Democratic Convention that nominated
the next president of the United States, John F. Kennedy.
Call to our party here and now is to produce for our nation a leader capable of again bringing Americans to their feet, tingling with pride and glowing with courage, not out of fear, but out of faith in America and a better world for all.
Selma sprang overnight from an obscure southern town to the front pages of world newspapers.
5 years later, as the South was still boiling, Collins went to Selma, Alabama at the request of then-President Lyndon Johnson. There, Collins met with Martin Luther King, Jr.
And there I found two opposing forces that were just arrayed, determined. They were absolutely deadlocked. There wasn't any motion anywhere. And they were heading right for another catastrophic confrontation.
And is credited with averting the violence that was widely anticipated.
This Alabama town will go down in the history books as a turning point in the civil rights drive.
Collins came back to Florida the next year and prepared a run for the United States Senate. He won the 1968 Democratic nomination, but was defeated in the general election, largely because of his efforts at Selma. Years later, Governor Collins made it clear that he had no regrets about losing that election.
When the general election went against me, I was deeply disappointed, but I was proud of what I did to advance civil rights. And if I had just remained silent and not done what I did, I would have forsaken what I strongly believed to be the right, and that would have been hard for me to live with.
To the end, Governor Collins remained unwaveringly dedicated to serving the state he so loved. His leadership, service, and hope for Florida's future continue to serve as the model for leaders in the Sunshine State.
Well, Governor Collins was a visionary leader. He took the state, he had a vision to change the state from a sleepy southern state to a state that was unique And he did it in a very dramatic way.
Former Governor Jeb Bush so admires Collins that he moved the former governor's official picture inside the gubernatorial suite, where it still hangs today.
He would have been rotated off that line of portraits because his service was a while back. And so I thought it was appropriate to keep him up there as a sign of respect for the kind of leadership that we always need.
I tell you now, I care.
Leroy Collins, without a doubt, one of the finest, most decent, admirable governors ever to serve, and a model of courage and vision for us all.